familiar, hallelujah. Daddy was a what is up, guys? Welcome back to another video on the channel. Today, we are going to be rebuilding the Detroit Lions. So, if you guys are new to the channel, make sure to drop a like and subscribe. And let's get straight into it. This is Madden 22. We're gonna have to create a league active roster. To import this real quick, so we can get all the players in.
Choose the team you want to start your franchise with.
The Lions. It's really hard to rebuild them, but I do think we can do it. I need a better QB for
stuff, though. The best
player on our team is the running back. So we need preseason here. So we're going to actually advance to the regular season. So we have the players that we can operate. But we're going to get a decent quarterback like Jalen Hurts or someone. Because honestly, I hate the QB we have right now. So if we take a look at the squad, it doesn't look too good. Alright, so we got DeAndre Swift, Jared Goff. We don't really have anybody. We got Penei Sewell.
This is the player card.
Alright, this is like our best guy. Arkansas. So we got like Gray for him to do defense. Do some power on this guy. Turn Jackson. And I think we're gonna trade Jared Goff. Let's upgrade him real quick though. Okay, trade value that way. And I think we're gonna keep DeAndre Swift. And let's take a look at the defense. Pretty darn bad. We're trying to get a cornerback. So first off, we're getting rid of that guy. So we go over here to, I think it is but it's trade center. We're gonna get a manual trade. And look for a like decent QB. Justin Fields honestly wouldn't be bad, but like Joe Burrow, I think that's a good offer. We'll give him Jared Goff. I was walking down a dark and then cold all alone on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we were sliding for a door. It's not even close, honestly. We're gonna share a drop, you know, like a 13. There we go. We got Joe Burrow. It should help us. We're not good. We need to upgrade our defense. I'm gonna say cornerbacks, like just some decent cornerbacks. It's honestly like AJ Boy, like that's fine. Yeah, AJ Boy, like this guy as well. Just to like upgrade the defense a bit. Didn't Fitzgerald retire? Remember we were sliding in for a door. We're picking them up. Welcome to the squad, Larry Fitzgerald. I don't think we're gonna do cap thing.
View your team, save
just
snapshots.
Because, like, that's stupid.
Quickly review the league's top performers.
I just don't like cap value in general. Because like it's annoying. I know you can hate me for this, but I don't like it. I'm gonna do all pro, it's like just as hard pretty much, at least for me. I'm just gonna turn that off. Everything that's good is fine. I'm gonna make a switch and fire my coach. I don't think I will though. So set a season goal. This season, moderate. I don't want to test because I don't think we'll win. If we do, that'd be surprised. So. No, we're not playing a season game. So this video will be one season game. We gotta get our roster somewhat decent for like anybody really. So we got Joe Burrow. We got Larry Fitz. I don't know if our quarterback so Boye's in. And then my strong safety went in. All I need is really a free safety. I'm gonna get a let's get a good we won't be good, but like, so like, honestly, we could get one from the Bears. The Bears have, or maybe the Sharks. Nope, yeah, they got Eddie Jones. That's like 7-4, and then we have like a bunch of draft picks. They might not I set up the play. I'm gonna make a move. And then it's gonna be a blitz. No, the third one. Yeah. Alright, so we got Eddie Jackson. So now our defense actually didn't even go up in overall. Which I guess is not really surprising. So now defense still not like looking insane, but like, you know, it's not like awful. So we're gonna just try our first game like this. I don't even know who our kicker is, but we're playing San Fran. Probably not gonna win this game. But you know, we'll try. I think I'm just gonna go one more receiver. We don't have anybody. I think this is just easier. I want Allen Robinson. I just want like a good receiver. Not like an insane wide receiver. Honestly, Pittman might be bad. I always have a lot of receivers. CeeDee Lamb. Wait. Nah, I don't see. First gonna play offense only, and here we go. Hope for the best, guys. So they have George Kittle and Fred Warner, and our punter's a superstar. That's great. You know, we have a good punter. It's gonna be tough. Man, I hope it's off. We gotta get this game.
Today.
We get the ball first. We'll do double slants here. And we'll test out CeeDee Lamb. They do have a star.
Now Burrow on first down. Flush to his right.
Flip it here to Hopkinson.
Let's go. Tight end Hopkinson. Hopkinson. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Now they go play action now. Burrow escaping the pressure.
I don't like any of that.
Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Let's try to run it.
So look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field.
Let's try to run it.
They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play.
Let's
That's the
Swift.
Mantra of every organization.
Let's go Swift.
The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well,
we can do
scouted
this
free agents
program.
Well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
I like him here.
throwing now. Burrow on first down. First down, Lions on a pick up of 13. And this one could be coming back.
It's always holding on the offense. I can't control that. That's the issue. It just doesn't.
That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you. And as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
He's open here.
Flushed out right.
Oh.
And fire deep downfield from Lamb. CeeDee Lamb is intended target. And it's second down.
Whenever you see a quarterback break contain, just think to yourself, the receivers on that side of the field, their number one job, make sure they get in his sight line so he can try and find someone downfield.
Here we go, Hawkinson.
The backside,
here we go,
make
Hawkinson.
Sure you don't give up the deep ball. They tried it there. They weren't able to connect.
This is third and one. Very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll try and run here with Swift.
But it doesn't matter.
And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
We have an RPO. I'm just going
to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Swift.
Let's go, Swift. Ah, you're
and a short game down to about the 33. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
I don't really like anyone here. Let's see if Lamb's open.
Here's Burrow. Eluding the pressure right, and he'll just get rid of it.
I was trying to look for Hawkinson there as well.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on
third down. I'm honestly looking for Swift here.
Now it's Burrow.
Swift is open. No!
Incomplete.
I will see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
We'll take the 3.
Patterson's kick is good. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead.
He almost missed that. Ooh, did we get like a pick?
So this offense will head back out there already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. First and 10,
it was a pick. Let's go, CeeDee Lamb.
That is caught by Lamb. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 18 yards that time to push him up first and goal.
Is that our quarterback?
They'll roll it with Williams. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
There we go. We got the
from the 2 now, second and goal.
I don't know who that was.
They'll run with Swift.
There we go.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown,
I did not see
Detroit.
And they don't get anything. Here's our
offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter.
I think I'm okay.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
What are you doing, Swift?
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He lost 4 there, and it's third down.
I don't like anybody here. Maybe Lamb. Or Fitzgerald, honestly.
Burrow looking to pass.
Throw
there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The NFC's Pro Bowl punter a year ago, Jack Fox, on to punt for the Lions. Back deep, Travis Benjamin. Taking it to 37.
Let's go.
EA Sports.
It's still 7-10.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Second
and so, CD, the big changes for 2021. Of course, last year we had the expansion from 6 to 7 teams in each conference making the playoffs. This year, the headline, the addition of a 17th regular season game. What did you think when you heard the news that this was happening?
Well, my first thought, partner, was finally, because we've heard about a 17th game coming for a long time, and now here it is. So the beautiful part about all of it is that 17th game is going to be like Swift.
You're wide open, buddy. There we go.
Games that are going to match up and go out over a four-year period. And that's kind of cool. And I was looking forward to seeing some of the matchups that are going to come out of that. For that 17th game, and could that be the game that decides a bunch of division titles?
On first and 10, it's Swift.
Oh,
and they work this forward for about three at second down.
Honestly, we got
not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter.
I don't trust
that.
That's sketchy. Hawkinson's open. Oh, keep going.
The middle into the hands of his tight end.
He's
complete. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 22-yard line.
TJ Hawkinson came into the NFL with big expectations. His big strides, they came in year two when his reception jumped from 32 as a rookie to 67 last year.
Give me a block,
they expect those numbers to continue to go up, and they will when he continues to make catches like that.
Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. 2 minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Steps away. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Again, it's Burrow.
But that's Lamb.
And that's going to wind up incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Patterson's kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Not too much time,
and we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
He said it for me in his kick.
Picked off by Quan Williams. And he'll be brought down around the 7-yard line.
I don't think that's right. All right, well, now we need to get
so the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts.
Let's go.
As they stop it here with just
Move
under 40
field.
Ticks to go
Move
in this
field.
First half. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb.
Ooh, it's
and
not
that's
going to
wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
We can easily hit a
field goal. So a costly penalty yardage-wise is that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
Off the play fake, here's Burrow. Rolling to his right. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
I just really want a touchdown here. We can't get it.
Burrow throw. Escaping the pressure right. He'll find Swift out of the backfield. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. They convert on third with a gain of 22.
We got a shot here. Try to get it.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
All of these throws are sketchy.
To throw again on second down. Burrow. Flushed out right. to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking it.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
From the 17, Burrow.
Oh no, that's a pick.
Defenders have intercepted.
Oh my God. Jimmy
Ward.
No.
And he'll get this back. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this off. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb.
Are you kidding me?
And that ball going to be intercepted yet again. Picked up by the all-pro corner, Josh Norman. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
Yeah,
that's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker. They turn that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. Now Burrow. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. On the handoff, this is Swift. And he'll get this up to about the 40. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And now they will throw it with Burrow.
Let's go,
to the left there and complete to the tight end, Hockenson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. He's up to 70 yards receiving now as that last catch gets him a first down. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide, because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy was going to catch it. He's sitting in the third row.
And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 31-yard line. First down, here's Burrow. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. Yeah, he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
And I bullet Hodge here.
To throw again on 2nd down.
Toss it. Aggressive kick that.
And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete. They tried the throw on 2nd down. Unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. To the air again, Burrow. Eluding the pressure right.
Let's go. Let's get
the throw. Back with one complete. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We are through 3 quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Williams. Nothing new in there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal.
Let's go, Swift.
And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown.
Run for 2 here. I'm just doing this manually. We need to get this one.
So now here come the Lions up to go for 2.
We're winning regardless here.
They'll give it to the fullback up the middle. And he will pull his way in there for the 2 points.
Then we'll go back to... how do we do this? Now. Is it not going to let me?
So that effort gives... The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Meanwhile, Burrow's throw taken in by Hockenson here. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards picking up the first. Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue where the game's going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. Running is Swift. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Once again, it's Swift. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again.
Really, you got nothing.
They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down.
You gotta get this here. Come on, Fitzgerald.
Now it's Burrow.
Wait, Burrow. Let's go!
Burrow gonna slide to the ground as he does pick up the first down. Burrow on his toes that time as they get the first down.
We get this first down, this game's over.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. They'll stay on the ground with Swift.
It's a first down.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 42 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown moves to boot. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. They'll run on first down. Swift.
Keep going, Swift.
Oh, he breaks a tackle and he's got an alley. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Here's Swift. And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the one. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Second and goal from the one.
They can use their last point.
They'll try to run this one in.
There we go.
Maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They will run it with Swift here. And Swift is not going to get there as they stop him short of the yellow line. No gain on the play. And what to do now on fourth and goal?
DeAndre Swift.
They'll try it now with Swift. And this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward. And indeed he did not.
I just screwed up the game.
So now we're in the final minute of the game
in
the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over.
Can I audible out of this? There we go. Now I like this.
Now Burrow. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. This is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, but it's going to be second down. Burrow. And he wants Reynolds way downfield. Final whistle blows, and we need some extra time here to decide who will be the victor. it's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. No, remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away.
Honestly, not bad. I'm trying to catch it in here.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone.
Right,
and that
job.
Decision
good
to bring
job.
It out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Okay, they didn't get
the Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Part one is done, now part two.
Oh my God.
They were looking for him
so
in the middle
much.
Third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
As a fan
of the NFL, for an opener, you can't ask for much more than this overtime in week one.
I know it's hard to believe that some people may not have been watching our game, but I'll bet through social media they found out one was snug and getting into overtime, and they flipped over here in a hurry. This is fantastic. If you're a fan of ball, you love these types of games.
Overtime, you have to be smarter than that.
A personal foul just can't happen. Have to have poise.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Nick Bosa. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. 2 minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied. Well behind the sticks here with a second and 18.
Yeah, hopefully he gets one. This might actually be over at this game. I got it.
They're going to look to throw. That's complete to Lamb.
Go, Lamb.
It's a pickup
right,
of 12.
Third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed
watching
how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Defensively, Jimmy Ward in on the stop. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settle it, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field.
And
he
got it.
The kick is good. In overtime, he's able to split the uprights. And with that, they will move out in front by 3. Well, I know it points to this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, your defensive guy. But it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was. And you know, people really enjoyed this.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys want more of these videos, please drop a like and subscribe. I'm probably going to be posting Madden 22 from now on. If you guys don't like it, I don't know what to do.
The players on your team quickly upgrade your team.
Madden,
this is the development tree. This is the ability
tree. I think that's what I'm going to do. Anyways, guys, see you guys in the next video. See you later. Peace.